amazing people. My name is Malebo Oljohn-Sindi. I am a holistic wellness coach and accredited meditation practitioner, and also an author of these two awesome books called The Journey and Confessions. And welcome to Malebo TV. Welcome to Malebo TV, a place of transformation and wellness. So today I want us to talk about triggers. What exactly are triggers? So triggers are the things that bothers you when another person lives their lives, right? So there's this woman, I saw this video from Unati, because I'm following Unati on Instagram, and this woman is actually acting on Muvango, or was acting on Muvango. And I remember that she lost her husband. I think the husband was killed. I don't remember the whole story, but I don't remember her name as well. Can you believe it? It has been a long time since I watched TV, especially Muvango. But then she lost her husband about 2 years ago, and now she's pregnant, obviously moving on with her life with another man, right? And human beings in South Africa and wherever believes that she moved on too fast, and she was not supposed to be pregnant, she was not supposed to be with another man. And this is now an appropriate example of why do we find a need to control other people's lives? Why other people's actions for their own life is triggering us? So people are our mirrors, and whatever bothers you about Malebo is a problem that you need to fix in you, not Malebo. Malebo has her own life. Malebo is living her own life. She's making her own decisions. And if her decisions are bothering you, then you are the person with problems. So a lot of times we have actually made it a mandate in our lives that we're going to control other people, we're going to speak ill about other people, we're going to be bothered that this one is working like this, this one is speaking English like that, and it bothers me. But everything that bothers you with another person's way of living, then you are the problem. And I know I had that same problem with this particular woman who was living her life. She didn't even know that I had a problem with her. And I want to be very honest, because I know it happens to any other human being out there. So this woman was just living her life, enjoying herself, doing whatever. And I had a problem with her living her life. And I asked myself, now, because, you know, the advantage with me is that I'm a coach and I work with these things, you know, this like my job. And I had to ask myself, why am I feeling this way about this particular human being when she is living her own life? And when I digged deeper, I found out that I was jealous, and my jealousy was brought from a point of lack, that this woman might take, you know, my clients, or this woman might do 1, 2, 3, and I was operating from a place of lack, and the lack now decided to come out as jealousy. And when I fixed the lack in me, then I found out that actually I don't have a problem with this person. They are living their lives, then it's okay. If they are going, they are coming back, it's okay. So I had to fix me in order for me to see this person as a human being who's just okay with everything, right? So many of times other people are triggering us with the things that they are doing, and we are blaming these people. We are even hating them, and we're going to be talking about this hate thing. We are even hating on them. We are speaking ill about them. We are doing all these things thinking we are right and they are wrong. But I am telling you, you are the person with a problem. If there is jealousy, you need to look at, where is this jealousy coming from? If it's coming from a point of lack, understand that there is an abundance of everything for every one of us. God knew that all of us, whether we are selling or we are speaking or we are doing whatever, the jobs and everything, there is an abundance of everything that we need. And whatever that you need, if you align yourself with it, then it will become. When I aligned myself with the desires of my heart, then I got the things that I wanted, and I stopped looking at this woman as if she was, you know, she was thinking that she's better than me. She was thinking, you know, those type of things. I looked at her as a, you know, an ordinary human being, and I actually do not have a problem with her. I figured out I had a problem with me, with my leg, because when you are operating from leg, you just want to control everything, and that's another thing. Another thing is that we want to control, like this woman on Muvango, who has moved on with her life and got another man who can love her, and they made a baby. I don't know if they had a baby with the other guy, but it doesn't matter. That's her life. Why do we now feel the need to control the decisions that she is making for herself? Because I mean, she's old and she was married and she knows better. So why do we always feel the need now of telling her how to live the life that we think she should live? Why can't we live that life? Why can't we be the representation of what we speak? Because most of the time, the things that we want other people to do are the very things that we don't even do. So whatever triggers you about another person is the very same thing that actually you have on the inside of you and you need to fix in order for you to have peace. And I have peace with that lady, you know. I'm not related to her. I just know her over TV just because she's a celebrity. And yeah, obviously her news will be known by everyone because she's in the public figure. But I don't have a problem with her moving with another man. I was not even related to the husband. I am not related to her. Even if I was related to her, I don't see how that can be a problem that she can move on with her own life. I mean, people have moved on with their own lives after they lost their husband, depending on how you mourn your husband, so, or your wife. But it is not now in my, you know, in my story that now I need to tell her how to live her life. Even me as a coach, I do not tell my clients how to live their lives. I just show them direction, and now they decide, because they have the power to decide. They decide whether they're going to go that direction or they're not going to go that direction. But whether they do or not, it shouldn't now become a problem that you're not doing this. Why don't you do this? You know, because there is now something wrong with you. The other thing that I want to talk about is the feelings and the emotions that we are giving out to the world. So there is a law, a universal law. It says it's the law of cause and effect. It says whatever that you put in out into this universe, you are going to get it back multiplied to you. So if you are giving hate to this lovely, beautiful woman who just decided to be pregnant and share the news with you, or you decided to be angry with me, hating me for maybe being here, or whatever the reason may be, then that same emotion, that same feeling, that same whatever is going out there in the universe, and it will be multiplied back to you. And you will now experience the hate that you give to other people. You will experience the hate that you give out to people, the pain that you give out to people. And if you then want to change your life, especially for people who are saying, I want to change my life, I want to... You need to understand that whatever that you are giving back will be multiplied back to you. Whatever that you're giving out will be multiplied back to you. So give out love. When people are deciding to live their life, when Malibu decides that she's going to train and she's going to have a baby and she's going to also have a husband, and then after that she's also going to read books, that's her. Give her love and love will be given back to you. And when we operate from a frequency of love, guys, you know, love, the Bible says love conquers all. When we operate from a place of love, we are conquerors. We're conquering. We are more, actually more than conquerors. And when we give love, I always see people saying, I love your energy. I love, you know, because the energy that I give is no longer the energy of hate that I talked about with this woman, the energy of jealousy, that I had jealousy over this woman. And now, because that energy has been taken out, I have, you know, intentionally taken it out from me, then people can see me for the true, you know, the authentic being that I, and they can see the love, they can see the energy of love, of peace, they can see the energy of happiness, of joy, because that is exactly now what I am giving out. I no longer give out hate, no longer give out jealousy, and I no longer give out the things that I don't want in my life. And when I give out love, peace, joy, and happiness, I get that back to me. So, how you fix your life? Look at the mirror. Look at the mirror. If Malebo is triggering you, then you need to fix yourself. And whatever that you are going to give to Malebo, whatever you are going to give to another person while you're driving and swearing at them, you're going to get that multiplied back to you. My name is Malebo. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel for all of this juicy stuff. I love you and take care of yourself. Bye-bye.